Genome technology is a thing. This means that scientists have the goods to reconstitute the genomes of a vanished species in a living form. It's called de-extinction. Not so much a zombie version of a lost species, but a real, breathing, thriving specimen, using genetic material from preserved specimens and archaeological artifacts. Some extinct species may actually be revivable. From Tasmanian tigers to saber-toothed tigers, from dodo birds to white dolphins. Ever seen a frog give birth through its mouth? You're about to. Thanks, science. This is 15 extinct animals scientists are going to revive. Number 15. Saber-toothed tiger. Here, kitty kitty. Imagine snuggling up to this in your bed at night. Its purr might keep you up, though. That is, if you survive having a saber-toothed tiger as a pet. But with DNA innovation and technology, resurrecting the apex cat could be a reality. They roamed the Americas as far back as 2.5 million years ago and ruled the land till about 10,000 years ago. And it's believed that it was humans who finally eradicated the saber-toothed tiger populations. However, there are many factors at work when a species can no longer thrive. Humans may have also killed much of the tiger's food supply. But if the saber-toothed tiger were to exist, we can assume their killing abilities aren't limited to size like modern cats of today. Modern-day apex cats can't kill animals that are much bigger in size than they are because they kill by strangling or breaking the necks of their victims. But paleontologists believe saber-toothed tigers may have used its signature sabers to slash their prey and let them bleed out. Then the tiger could step back and wait. Dinner time. We doubt they'd make great pets. However, if scientists get their way, we might actually be able to take saber-toothed tigers for a walk, although we doubt this beast would compete for anything with a human, much less food. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14, woolly rhinoceros. We bet you haven't seen a rhinoceros like this, but they were once very much real, and specimens found in the Arctic tundra of northeastern Siberia date back 50,000 years. They were huge, too, sometimes 16 feet at the shoulders and weighing over 20 tons. But you might not believe this, woolly rhinos and humans appear to live in harmony for thousands of years, and perhaps if we resurrect this species, we could do so again. The most recent specimens found in the Albisky region of Yakutia in northeastern Russia are revealing just what happened to the specimens. Early human settlers in Siberia were nomadic, but once that changed and nomads started creating permanent settlements, like towns and cities, changes in food sources and habitat may have damaged the rhino population. But they thrived throughout Europe and northern Asia during the Pleistocene epoch until the end of the last glacial period. Images of woolly rhinoceroses have even been found in cave paintings throughout Europe and Asia, only proving that humans and woolly rhinos coexisted successfully at some point. Could that be a reality again? Rhinos of today are typically gentle and keep to themselves, but if they are threatened, they'll move their bodies into an attack stance and charge. Number 13. The dodo. In popular culture, the dodo has a strange reputation because it's, for lack of a better word, a strange-looking bird. But that's not going to stop scientists from bringing the dodo back from extinction through the magic of cloning. The cuckoo flightless birds can be revived from their extinction due to the fact that they have such close living relatives. The dodo was endemic to the island of Mauritius, east of Madagascar in the Indian Ocean. But for scientists looking to clone the bird, finding dodo DNA is also a huge challenge. After all, the dodo has been extinct since the 1800s. DNA decays easily in warm climates, and since the dodo was endemic to a tropical island, the bones found there didn't contain usable DNA. However, scientists were able to sequence dodo DNA using bones stored in Amsterdam. In theory, to create dodos, scientists would take an emu egg and, during the early stages of embryonic development, then they can inject gene-edited pigeon cells into the equation. This method has recently been proven successful in chickens where scientists restored rare chicken breeds using genetically engineered chickens. Number 12. The aurochs. These ancestors of domestic cattle are an extinct species of large wild cattle that inhabited Asia, Europe, and North Africa back in the day. The oldest remains of this long extinct cow have been dated to about 2 million years ago in India. As long as there have been humans, aurochs have been deep within the human psyche and were quite prominent in indigenous cave drawings and tribal art. So, why resurrect them? According to the Roman Emperor Julius Caesar, their strength and speed are extraordinary. That's why scientists want to attempt to bring aurochs back through a process called backbreeding. The aurochs characteristics have survived, genetically scattered throughout its descendants like cows and oxen of today. By breeding these animals together and selecting offspring that show more auroch-like traits, the theory is that we can eventually recreate them, or something similar, by literally breeding backwards. In 2015, scientists were able to sequence the first full aurochs genome from one single fossilized specimen. However, there's a lot of work still to be done. But the potential is there to bring these cows back to life. Number 11. Yangtze Freshwater Dolphin. Animal conservationists believe they've achieved the impossible. A freshwater dolphin that graced the Yangtze River for 20 million years and was declared extinct in 2006 was reported to have been seen again on a stretch of Asia's longest river near the city of Wuhu, China. The so-called goddess of the Yangtze was spotted by conservationists. The very rare and mysterious white freshwater dolphin. Historically, the species, also called Baiji, had been revered to almost mythical proportions amongst fishermen. The freshwater dolphins were believed to be reincarnations of princesses who had passed away and were a sign of good luck. And if, in fact, the dolphin did make an appearance again, this would be very exciting for scientists and conservationists alike. They believe that the Yangtze freshwater dolphin was no more. In the 1950s, the river contained an estimated 6,000 dolphins. Only a few hundred were left by 1970. Then the number dropped down to 400 by the 1980s, and then less than 20 by 1997. According to the Guinness Book of World Records, the Baiji was last sighted in August 2004. However, in 2007, a man reportedly videotaped a large white animal swimming in the legendary river. Number 10. The Moa Bird. This flightless bird used to inhabit parts of New Zealand until it went extinct in the late 13th century. They were the largest terrestrial animals and dominant herbivores on the island. But Moa extinction occurred within 100 years of human settlement thanks to overhunting. Moa were a popular meaty food option. However, scientists are actually pretty close to bringing back the Moa bird. Experts at Harvard University have assembled a nearly complete genome of the extinct Moa, and that's exactly what you need if you plan to resurrect an extinct animal. That and a new form of DNA sequencing called high-throughput sequencing to determine the little bush moa's nuclear genome. And they extracted ancient DNA from a single toe bone of a moa specimen from the Royal Ontario Museum in Toronto. Harvard scientists then slipped the DNA into the egg of a living species. They pieced together 900 million nucleotides and matched them to a specific location on the genome of an emu, the closest living relative of the moa bird. The Genetic Rescue Foundation, based in New Zealand, stated that their primary goal was to create the most detailed moa genome possible in order to advance our understanding of one of the most iconic birds that ever lived. Number 9. The Tasmanian Tiger. You may have heard of a Tasmanian devil, but did you know there was a such thing as a Tasmanian tiger? It turns out the Tasmanian tiger is nothing like a cat. They are a marsupial. In fact, an extinct carnivorous marsupial native to Australia and the islands of Tasmania and New Guinea. The last living specimen died in 1936, but it was only declared extinct in 1986. Locals kept seeing them, or so they thought. But great news, scientists are closer than ever to bringing extinct Tasmanian tigers back to life. Experts successfully sequenced its genome using genetic material from a flawlessly preserved specimen of a 4-week-old baby Tasmanian tiger. That's some science fiction type stuff right there. So, what would be the next best thing to do after you achieved such a magnificent thing? Cloning. That's right. Thanks to ever-growing technological advances, they're already looking to clone the animal. The last known living animal was captured in 1930 in Tasmania. However, there have been alleged sightings of the Tasmanian tiger throughout the 20th century. Number 8. The quagga. They're like zebras, except the quagga has stripes that only appear on the front half of their bodies. And for zebra enthusiasts, it's kind of a big deal. Scientists have bred a version of the quagga that looks incredibly similar. A little backstory, the quagga was a subspecies of the plains zebra, and it was unique to South Africa until it was hunted to extinction in the late 19th century. In 1984, the quagga was the first extinct animal to have its DNA analyzed. the Quagga Project was created in an attempt to recreate them, their hair, coat pattern, and related characteristics by selectively breeding the genetically closest subspecies, Burchell's zebra, and they succeeded. A foal was born in 1988, and in 2005, a foal with the most quagga-like striping was born, followed by a fifth-generation foal in 2013. By 2016, the Quagga Project listed 116 animals in 10 locations. Of the 116 animals, 6 individuals showed a strongly reduced stripe pattern. The project's ideal population would consist of 50 quagga-like zebras. Once the project reached their goal, they'd move the quagga clones to a protected area within their formal natural habitat in South Africa, taking into account the ecological adaptations or behavior differences in the original animal. Number 7. The Pyrenean Ibex. What'd you call me? We joke because it's fun to say, but have you ever heard of a Pyrenean Ibex? I'll say that 10 times fast. But since we're here, the Pyrenean Ibex is actually a wild goat with epic horns endemic to the Pyrenees, a mountain range straddling the border of France and Spain. But in the year 2000, Pyrenean Ibex became extinct before scientists could learn more about them. But that didn't stop them from trying to clone one. Celia, the last Ibex, was captured and tagged, and skin biopsies from her ear were cryopreserved in nitrogen. She died a year later. The Spanish government let scientists try to clone her from these DNA samples. However, their attempts ended in 2010, after the birth of a cloned Pyrenean Ibex. But sadly, it died after only a few minutes. It was decided that the wild goat's cousin, the Spanish Ibex, would be introduced to the Pyrenees mountain ranges instead. It took until 2014 to successfully release the first of the new wild goats into the region. And now, a new generation of the Western Spanish Ibex were seen in France. The total French population of the new Ibex is now at around 400. Quite an achievement. Number 6. Caspian Tigers. This mighty cat used to rule the range from Turkey to Mesopotamia, Central Asia to Western China. Caspian tigers inhabited forests and riverine corridors in this region until its extinction was confirmed in 2003. However, Caspian tigers lived alongside its cousin, the Siberian tiger, and shared a common continuous geographic distribution until the early 19th century. DNA evidence, however, reveals other possibilities. Have we seen the last of this tiger of the riverbanks? Now scientists are working to bring the Caspian tiger back to life. Since the Siberian tiger is the closest relative to the Caspian, the Siberian tiger could be appropriate for reintroduction into Central Asia, like their Caspian tiger cousins. Experts figured that 100 animals would require at least 1,900 square miles of habitat, rich with prey, which isn't that easy to find. Turns out areas of Central Asia are indeed suitable for tigers. What are the prospects for the Caspian tiger? Will it return to Central Asia by the Year of the Tiger in 2022? Fingers crossed. That's the goal of the Worldwide Fund for Nature effort, a partnership with the government of Kazakhstan and the Kazakhstan Geographic Society. Number 5. Gastric brooding frogs. This frog was native to a small portion of Queensland, Australia, but it went extinct in the 1980s, believed to be caused by a disease that stems from a fungus spread by humans. But what made this frog so fascinating to researchers was the fact that the gastric brooding frog gave birth through its mouth, the only frog known to do that. According to researchers, the frog would lay eggs and then swallow them. Around 20 to 25 tadpoles would eventually crawl out of the mama's mouth. Well, she actually puked her baby frogs out. True story. And for this reason, researchers are trying hard to bring one of the world's weirdest frogs back to life through the magic of cloning. Cue the science fiction music. Researchers found a related frog which also lives in the same region in Australia. The scientists deactivated the related frog eggs and replaced them with preserved eggs taken from gastric brooding frogs. They implanted the dead cell nucleus from the extinct species into a fresh egg from another related frog. While none of the resulting embryos survived, tests confirmed they were full of the genetic juice from the extinct frog. So, there's still a chance to bring back the gastric brooding frog. Number 4. Steller's Sea Cow. Aside from whales, the gargantuan Steller's Sea Cow could hold the title of the largest mammal to live in the modern age. They could grow to over 30 feet long and weigh as much as a city bus. And if scientists could, they would be cloning these amazing specimens right now. The Steller's Sea Cow is the first historical extinction of a marine mammal by human hands, wiped out by fur traders and seal hunters. The slow-moving and easily caught mammal was valued for its nutritious meat, fat, and hide. In particular, it was Europeans' lust for luxury items like fur hats and coats that led to Steller's sea cow falling prey to the international fur trade. The fact that it took less than 30 years for Steller's sea cow to be driven to extinction suggests the sea cows were probably never that numerous to begin with. They didn't realize how fragile the population was at the time, and that's why scientists are so intent on finding their DNA. They were first described by George Wilhelm Steller in 1741 around the Commander Islands between Alaska and Russia on the Great Northern Expedition. Much of what is known about the sea cow's behavior comes from Steller's observations. But what we didn't know about conservation then, we certainly know now. Justice for Steller's sea cow. Number 3. The elephant bird. What happened to this mysterious animal? The extinction could have been caused by climate change or perhaps deforestation in quest for human progress. Maybe the elephant bird was hunted to extinction, who knows? But the elephant bird was many times bigger than what we commonly know as an ostrich. That's a big bird. The flightless elephant bird from Madagascar stood 10 feet tall and laid bird eggs, like really, really big, enough to make 50 Denver omelets. But could DNA technology and cloning be the best way to find out what these birds are capable of? Some experts think so. It's very much possible to use these genetic codes to bring elephant birds back Jurassic Park style. Nature finds a way, just sometimes with a little bit of science to boost its power. There is indeed evidence that the elephant bird's eggs were particularly valuable as a food source. Eggs regularly provided meals for entire families, but also as a luxury item. The bird's eggshells were used as bowls or crafted into jewelry, but there's also evidence that they were wiped out by disease. Nonetheless, it's confirmed that humans and elephant birds coexisted for generations. Number 2. Ground sloth. Ever heard the term megafauna? Well, get ready to have mega fun. Meet the Megatherium americanum, aka the ground sloth. Fossils of this impressive animal have been recovered from about 150 sites across North America, although it also roamed the grasslands of South America. And as you know, sloths are built for speed. This ground sloth did weigh in at over 2 tons, despite being a gentle herbivore. It was able to stand and walk on its hind legs too. The ground sloth is the largest bipedal mammal of all time. Almost 12,000 years ago, by the end of the Great Ice Age, evidence shows that the giant ground sloths have become extinct. However, there are people who believe they thrived for thousands of years after that on remote Caribbean islands. Could there be a ground sloth alive somewhere out there? Probably not, but that won't stop scientists from possibly cloning the ground sloth. Or maybe they can merge existing sloth DNA with a living relative of the unique species. Discovered in 1787 in Argentina, the first ground sloth fossils were shipped to the National Science Museum in Madrid, Spain. And scientists used 3D scanning to create 3D versions of ground sloth specimens. Number 1. The woolly mammoth. Are these shaggy-coated giants really poised to stampede across the frozen wastelands of Siberia anytime soon? That concept seems to be on the lips of experts in news services around the world. Headlines like, "On the verge of resurrection" and "We'll be back from extinction within 2 years," could this be true? The resurrection of the woolly mammoth is the most celebrated example of species de-extinction, the process of bringing vanished species back to life. In 2017, a Harvard University geneticist predicted that within 2 years, they would have succeeded in making genetically modified elephant embryos resemble those of the woolly mammoth. This would require recovering intact genetic material from a woolly mammoth cell, which would be transferred to an egg from an elephant, and then implanting the resulting embryo into the uterus of a female elephant. In essence, they were trying to make a mammophant, half extinct woolly mammoth, half modern-day elephant. The bioengineering, genome research, cellular resources, and reproductive techniques that the Woolly Mammoth Revival Project utilizes will take years to successfully pull off, but it will enhance our understanding and ability to conserve elephant species.